really good posture. We are micromanaging stuff, but you are going to see people like that that come in that are not functioning that well. So you can't always be deceived by ideal posture and gait. You've got to look for the needle in the haystack. Okay? So looking straight ahead, ideally you want the ear lined up with the middle of the shoulder, with the hip bone, with the outside of the knee, with the lateral malleolus, and hers is pretty perfect.
No, thank you.
You've been doing revolution motion how long? Okay, so make notations of that, and you can start again at the head and see what the neck is doing. So you want a nice, smooth cervical curve that rounds forward, and then you want a slight convexity in the thoracic region, so that would be a kyphosis, but you're supposed to have a kyphosis. So this is lordosis going this way, kyphosis going that way, and then another lordosis. So those are your three curves. Right. Now, and you can tell Hay to just make sure that you're not feeling every single bump here right on the surface, because that would show that it's a kyphosis in the cervical region or a reverse curve. And she's got a very nice curve going there. I would like to see her, if she has her C6 protruding a little bit too posterior, so that would be a little bit too early in her curve to have it start coming out. And she's a bit too flat through her kyphosis. And as I palpate through here, there's a bit of tension through here. So I'm looking at Luzanne and getting a sense that from here to here probably is a problem area that needs more mobilization. All right? She's done a brilliant job of really restoring function very well and these things lining up. But remember, we have to look for the needle in the haystack. So this is the area. And that's where palpation skills come in. Like, there's a give that you want to feel. Think about the tone in here. Think about the ball reflecting in the tone through here. Okay? So this is an area that will get you. Right. And so her curve looks great there. Now, even though this lines up pretty well, I would like to see not quite as much of the humerus rolling forward here. Now, that could be consistent with this area not working as well as I'd like it to. So we should see changes in where her, how her humerus fits in her scapula. Okay? Alright, so then we go down and that all looks good. So it's very easy to see hyperextension of the knee from the lateral view. You'll also be able to see arm imbalances there. The most important thing that you get to see from the side profile is if their head is too far forward and what their curve